There are no such things as free real estate leads. Well, that's not exactly right, at least when it comes to upfront costs for leads. Why? Because there are providers in the market that offer real estate leads that you only have to pay when you close them. You then usually have to pay a referral fee that can range between 25% and 50% of your total gross commission. In this video, I will discuss how this real estate leads paid at closing concept works, give you two providers that offer the service, and show you the risks and benefits of using them. You will also find out when it makes sense to use them and when not. So how does this whole thing with real estate leads paid at closing work? Well, the concept is pretty simple. There are several providers in the market that offer real estate leads at no upfront costs, and you only pay them when you close a deal with a particular lead. You then pay the provider a referral fee that can range between 25 and 50% of the total commission you receive. Some providers offer exclusively leads while others don't. And depending on the exclusivity and the quality of the leads, providers can be quite picky and don't accept any real estate professional as a client for that. It can also happen that they attach some conditions to the usage of the lead. For example, they might also want you to pay further referral fees if the lead referred becomes a repeat customer. So many times you don't really own the lead you get. Now, here come the two providers I would like to mention, at least in this video. In my article on hackingrealestatemarketing.com about the same subject, I have a longer list of 9 providers. You will find a link to this article in the description below. The first one to mention is Homelight. In contrast to other providers, they give a bit more details about the process to become an agent that can receive referrals. In order to find the agent that is best for the buyers, they analyze many different transactions, 25 million to be exact, and several thousand reviews. A matching algorithm is used to find the right fit between agents and qualified referrals. The algorithm takes many different performance metrics and other data points into consideration, such as your transaction volume by year, the numbers of days on the market related to properties based on historical transaction, the price point, property type, and geographic expertise, the overall success rate with Homelight referrals, the relation between the average sales price and average listing price, reviews from past clients, and your response time to Homelight referrals. So the better these metrics are, the more referrals you can get with Homelight. When you close with a Homelight referral, you will have to pay a standard broker to broker referral fee, which is 25% of half of the total gross commission. Why don't they just say 12.5% of the total gross commission? I don't know. This referral fee triggers within 2 years of the date of the referral and includes multiple transactions. The second one is Agent Harvest, and they have a slightly stronger focus on listing referrals. More than 60% belong to this category and are single family listings in 95% of the cases. Also, the majority of these referral leads actually want to work with agents and not just want to use them to gather information. As with the other providers I included in my articles, the referral fee, in this case 25% of the total gross commission, is due at closing and nothing else has to be paid upfront. Agent Harvest works only with 3 agents per geographic area, and the referrals are all sent to these agents at the same time once generated. Besides listing referrals, the company can also provide you with residential lease referrals at a reduced referral fee of 15%. In my article on hackingrealestatemarketing.com about the same subject, I have also a nice table where you can find the referral fees of all the providers I researched at a glance. Now, there are also 4 benefits and 3 risks of using this type of real estate lead providers. Let's start with the 4 benefits. Because you don't have upfront costs, there is no monetary risk when it comes to generating leads. You have higher chances of getting better quality leads, because if the provider doesn't give you quality, they don't get paid. You save time by not having to work on your real estate marketing and lead generation methods and strategies, and you have higher chances of receiving exclusive leads. Now, what are the 3 risks? Unfortunately, real estate starters and intermediates that usually have much higher need for leads will often not get in these programs. As you might have noted, the 2 providers I mentioned mostly want top agents. The referral fees can be pretty high, and depending on your sales and follow-up skills, it might be a better bet to pay for leads upfront with other providers. And depending on the referral agreement with such providers, you may have to pay further referral fees, from future transactions, you also might not be allowed to market to them long term, for example, past client marketing. So ending this video and concluding, as an advanced and experienced real estate agent, it can make sense to use providers that offer you leads paid at closing, provided you know your key performance indicators. Why? Because if you know how good you are when it comes to your sales and follow-up skills, you might also want to choose a provider that doesn't have too many strings attached and wouldn't charge a refer fee too far into the future from the date of the first referral sent to you. Of course, I wouldn't use one of these services if you have already a well-oiled and tested real estate marketing machine, a place that generates good leads on a consistent basis. Overall, I would make this decision dependent on the marketing ROI you have in your business. So that's it for today. I hope this was informative, and well, thanks for watching and see you next time. Give me a thumbs up. Okay, bye bye.